for somehow being able to stick with us and support us throughout our rebellious teenage years. And to Coach Mack, who should be sitting here with us today, who pushed me harder than anyone else and cared so much about us all. I'm going to try and keep this speech pretty short and sweet. For one, I don't want Puddin falling asleep on me as he does at school on occasion. Secondly, I know that Dylan Douglas, Taylor Dishman, and Kevin Bartley can't sit still for more than 5 or 10 minutes at a time. In fact, I have a feeling they're getting antsy already. So, to the class of 2010, congratulations. We've made it. We've made it through all the high school drama, the fights, the breakups, the rumors. We've made it through two-a-day football and volleyball practices that were debilitating to the point that simply walking was a feat in itself. We've made it through muddy walks through the portable buildings. We've made it through Mrs. Moore's junior English class, where we learned so much and where we would get our papers, desk, and hands searched to make sure we didn't cheat. We made it through the reign of Mr. Mancini. We've made it through our senior year with the kid from Iowa in our grade. Some good, some bad, but all unforgettable. The next question is, what now? Our futures are now, more than ever, dependent on us. As we head out on our own, we will no longer have our parents and teachers to guide us through every step of the way. For 18 years, we have more or less taken a back seat in our lives. But now, we're driving. Where will you go? Many of us are going to a university or college, or saving up to go there. Some of us are jumping straight into the real world to find a job and make a living. Others are going to serve our country in the military. I am of no stature to tell you how to live your lives, except for the fact that I have the microphone and you do not. But since I do have the microphone, here is my advice to you, with some help, from Dr. Seuss, my all-time favorite author. Besides, he would be David Thoreau, of course. First, be who you are and say what you feel, because those who mind don't matter, and those who matter don't mind. So don't live your life by only listening to what other people say. Listen to advice from others, but don't let people steer you away from what you know is best. Find something that you love to do, do it passionately, and your life will be a success. Only you truly know what is best for you, and the people in your life who matter will support you and encourage you along the way. Second, if things start happening, don't worry, don't stew. Just go right along and you'll start happening too. Whether big or small, we are all bound to run into obstacles in our lives. But no matter what you face, it is important to never, ever give up. As cliche as this may sound, it's great advice. Nothing is really over until the moment you stop trying. Third, think left and think right, and think low and think high, all the things you can think of if only you try. Everyone needs to dream, because without dreams, your life will have no purpose. You should always set your hopes and dreams high and work your butt off to achieve them.